Shalom, I'd like to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and elders of GMS that taught us this word. I just wanted to examine this word confidence, because it's very important to, you know, have confidence in this truth, which goes back to, you know, faith, and that true belief and that assurance, you know, that the Lord is with you, the assurance that you have, and the knowledge, and the assurance that this truth is real, man. That the Lord is with us. You gotta have that confidence. You know, if you watch these dating coaches, you know, online, they talk about, you know, if you want to get a woman, you gotta have that confidence, that assurity that you can get her. You know, that faith in yourself, but not just, you know, in women, but in all things. You know, faith in a particular job. You know, faith or confidence in a particular job that you want to get, or confidence in whatever, in any endeavor that you choose to take part in. So it's very important to have that confidence. But how do you get that confidence? You know, you gotta work at it. It's not just something that you just have. You know, like when you're in the gym and you're working out, you know, for years, you develop, you know, a structure to your body. Know, muscular structure, and then you develop more confidence in your working out, in your self-appearance, because you put in the work. You know, much like with the scriptures, but you put in the work and you will get confidence in this truth. The Most High will put you through some spiritual situations, and that builds your faith as well, you know. But in Etymology Online Dictionary, the word confidence is assurance or belief in the goodwill, you know, veracity of another, firmly trusting, bold. Scripture says, you know, the righteous man is bold, you know, bold as a lion out there, you know. To have full trust or reliance, full trust, you know, you got to put your trust in Yahweh Shai, man. Reliance on one's own powers, resources, or circumstances. Self-assurance. You know, that belief in yourself, you know, that you can do this thing, that you can do whatever. And you gotta have that faith when it comes to this truth, you know. A lot of guys don't have that, you know, because they truly don't believe. You know, it's that experience. Going out there getting that experience. The first scripture is Hebrews 3:6. I'll start at 5. And Moses verily was faithful in all his house as a servant for a testimony of those things which were to be spoken after. But Yahweh Shai as a son over his own house, whose house are we, if we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of the hope firm unto the end. You know, it's all about that endurance unto the end, man. No matter how rough it gets and no matter how long you think you've been in it, you know, there's men over you that have been in it longer, you know. And you gotta hold that confidence unto the very end. If we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of the hope firm unto the end, you know. That comfort that the scripture brings, I'm talking about the kingdom, talking about the chariots, what's good to come, you know. Rejoicing of the hope firm unto the end, because that's our hope, to be delivered out of here. And having our kingdom set up, you know, our rulership, that's our hope. And we all have confidence in that. That's going to come one day. That's our belief, that's our faith. And we're going to hold fast unto that and endure unto the end, man. No matter how rough it gets, because what else do we have? You know, what else do we have to look forward to? You know, the black woman? You know, I have to look forward to her one day getting her act together? You know? What do we have to look forward to? Black Wall Street Part 2? You know, the new Black Wall Street? You think that's going to get built up in America? No. We're looking forward to the kingdom, man. When Yahweh Shai comes back. You yeah, if you look up that word, confidence in that scripture, where there is a parousia, and it means freedom in speaking, unreservedness in speech, the unreservedness, you know, out there boldly speaking, you know, openly, frankly, without concealment. You know, we don't hold back nothing of the truth. We teach this entire Bible, you know, we don't hold nothing back without ambiguity or circumlocution, without the use of figures and comparisons, free and fearless confidence, cheerful courage, boldness, assurance. Yeah, that's why boldness, that word bold just keeps coming up, man. All outspokenness, frankness, bluntness, you know, that confidence, you know, that assurity of what we're talking about, because we have that belief and that faith, you know, goes back to faith. Next scripture is Hebrews 10:35. Cast not away therefore your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. You know, cast not away. And there are certain guys that come in and they cast it away, you know. They didn't have that belief, that confidence in the truth in the scriptures in Yahweh Shai. They took it and they just walked off, you know. They got kicked out. You know, you don't want to cast away this confidence, man. This is our comfort, man. This is our heritage, our truth. This is who we are, man. You're not supposed to cast that off. Because that does, like the scripture said right here, is which hath great recompense of reward. We want that reward, man. We're sick of being at the bottom. No, I am. I'm tired of being at the bottom of the barrel in society, you know. I want rulership, man. I want to be on top, you know. Next scripture is 1 John 2:28. And now, little children, abide in him, that when he shall appear, you may have confidence and be not ashamed before his coming. Yeah, you know, we'd abide in who? Yahweh Shai. Abide in this truth. So when he comes back, you know, we have nothing to be ashamed of. It's like, hey, we did the work. We came out here, you know. We endured until the end. We taught the truth. We taught the name, the spirit, and the truth. You know, we're not going to be ashamed in that day. Lord will. You know, we strive unto the end. The Lord will. The Most High keeps that spirit in us. You know, that confidence within us. You know, and taking out that Holy Spirit. And being not ashamed before him at his coming. And when's he coming? You know, back during that World War III. You know, when he appears in the sky with all the angels. Thousands in heaven for that war in heaven. You know, those angels, those chariots. You know, Lord will, we're not going to be ashamed in that day. It's spoken about in the scriptures. This is Zephaniah 3:8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord power, until the day that I rise up to the prey. You know, we're not supposed to be out there trying to fight Esau. And we're not supposed to be out there, you know, raising ruckus, raising hell. The only hell we're supposed to be raising is through this truth, through our words, you know. You ain't gonna see us out there, you know, commit crimes, you know, trying to take down Esau. We can't do that. We gotta wait for the Yahweh Shai. It said right here, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until I rise up to pray. Because Yahweh Shai is gonna be the one that's gonna liberate us. Yahweh Shai is gonna be the one that's gonna deliver us. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, and pour upon them my indignation. Yeah, gather the nations. In the Middle East, that World War III. And that way, the Most High is going to pour out his indignation through them ICBM missiles, man, the nuclear missiles. Even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. Yeah, the missiles, man. And we have confidence that's going to happen. You know, we see it in the news every everybody's upgrading their military might. Russia being the prime example. You know, we're seeing that. We have confidence it's going to happen. We have confidence the Lord's going to deliver us, man. The Lord will. And the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. You know, we don't want to get caught up in that. You know, we want to be delivered up out of that missile destruction that's going to destroy America. You know, so yeah, it's all about, you know, that true faith that you have to have and just enduring, you know, just keep pushing on, you know. So, you know, with that, shalom all.